Direct from Los Angeles, the Auto Channel presents exclusive press pass coverage of the 2008 LA Auto Show.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Very warm welcome to Spyker. My name is Victor Mueller. I'm the CEO and founder of the company. And I'm very pleased to show you today the developments that we have gone through in the past year. It's been a rough ride for the industry, but strange as it may seem, very small high-end manufacturers such as Spyker just seem to escape the very harsh circumstances in the market for the time being, at least. We have seen no drop in demand. Since we're very global, we see a lot of demand from the Middle East and China. And even our American distribution is not facing any hardship because we do not oversupply our product. We're very small, so we make maybe 100 cars next year, and half of them will go to the United States. With 15 dealers, that's an average of three and a half cars per dealer. And based on that, you will not find a lot of stock of our product around, which is good. It's good for residual values, it's good for our customers, and it's particularly very good for our partners, our dealers. So Spyker has had a very good year so far, and it stands to be a better year for us next year. We'll double our production this year, and we're looking to double our production again next year. Today we have brought two cars to Los Angeles that are new to this market. And the first car is the C8 Aileron. It is the second generation Spyker C8 after the introduction of our first car in the year 2000. This is the second generation. And the second generation, historically, they're always much improved over the first generation, and I can only say that that is the case here too. The major improvement of this product versus the first generation is the fact that it carries an automatic gearbox. Since the year 2000 that we started our company, this market has seen a dramatic turn for automatic gearboxes, something that was inconceivable, let's say, 10 or 15 years ago. Every single sports car now has either an automated manual transmission with paddle shift or, alternatively, an automatic gearbox. And unfortunately, the short wheelbase cars that we manufacture just couldn't take an automatic gearbox. Their physical configuration wouldn't allow for it. So we created the Aileron with a long wheelbase and a long tail, which houses the ZF 6-speed automatic gearbox. We anticipate building about 95% of our production with automatic gearboxes next year. The first car has just gone into production, and it is going to be on these shores by first quarter of next year. Order intake has been very good, and we expect this car to be a big hit for us, particularly when we come out with the Spyder version at the Salon in Geneva in March of next year. The Aileron is not only in terms of its design, which is very much inspired on the aviation heritage of our business. Spyker was an aircraft manufacturer between 1914 and 1918, but we've taken it to the next generation. Whilst the air inlets, for instance, of the short wheelbase models are very much also aircraft inspired, but the propeller logo was basically leading in its design, we've taken it up now to the next generation of aircraft design, and that was going into turbine engines. So you will find turbine wheels and turbine air inlets on this car. Basically, a Spyker is an aircraft with no wings. That's our design philosophy. We race our cars very intensely and very successfully, usually at Le Mans and the Le Mans series. And in order to basically pay homage to the racing heritage of our company, we decided to create a very limited edition Le Mans knockoff, as we could call it, a replica. And that is the LM85 to my left here. We will build 24 of them, 12 of which will go to America. This is actually the first one that we brought into the country, so 11 more to follow. And it is a totally hand-built, all-aluminum space frame. This car has the color scheme of our cars, but it also has all of the design features that we see on our Le Mans cars, the GT2 cars. It has the black Alcantara interior, and it has the propeller wheels, the AP Racing brakes that we use for Le Mans. So it's really, truly a road version of a GT2 Le Mans car. there's a lot of demand for limited edition nowadays. Everybody in this industry brings out limited editions, and usually they're sold to collectors in a heartbeat, and this car is no exception. The car as such is not what the owner gets. He gets much more than that. He gets a 2009 Le Mans package. It means two people, the buyer and his wife or partner, will be invited to come to Le Mans next year with Spyker and enjoy the Le Mans weekend. Completely submerged in the Le Mans experience. For those of you who have visited 24 Hours Le Mans, it's basically the best sports car event that one could ever visit. It is absolutely overwhelming. It's up right up there with the Indy 500 and the Monaco Grand Prix. This car also comes with a dedicated Chronosuisse watch. It's a 24-hour watch with an orange band, and it is part of the package that the owner gets when he buys the car. The way it stands, we will have 24 guests next year at Le Mans who actually own an LM85, and most of them will be bringing their cars to Le Mans. And we've arranged with the organization of Le Mans that they can actually do a lap with their LM85 on the Le Mans track during the race. Oh, not during the race, that would be very difficult. That would cause some problems, I would guess, but just prior to the race. We will have two cars in the race, but they will be looking slightly different. Well, that is what is happening today. Our distribution in America is expanding. As I said, we will be sending about 50% of our production next year again into the United States. And you never know what's going to happen in the American market, but if everything keeps on going the way it currently goes, we will see a very massive improvement of our sales in this country. And again, as I said, a small manufacturer, very high-end, our customers, and I'm telling you this based on personal experience, our customers are so irritated with the fact that they buy a stock today and find it's worth 50% of that tomorrow, that they rather buy a car, because if it's not appreciating, it's certainly not depreciating very quickly, and it's certainly not worth half tomorrow. And in the meantime, at least you have some fun with it. That is what I have to say to you about Spyker in Los Angeles today. And please get your package. And if you have any questions, just kindly let me know. Thank you very much.
Thanks for watching the Auto Channel. For more press pass coverage of the LA Auto Show and all other major auto shows, visit theautochannel.com, the internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive information resource.